Hey everybody, in this video we're going to talk about psychographics and demographics, why each one is different and why they're both very important, especially when you use them together. So by the end of the video you're going to be able to understand exactly how to figure out what the psychographics and the demographics are and create content and marketing and ads that are going to be far more effective. So let's get into today's video. Hey there, my name is Brandon Brashears. I create daily digital marketing videos. So if you're trying to grow your brand or your business with digital marketing, this is a great place. I also vlog about creating my agency and my business here. So if you're trying to grow your business, be sure and subscribe. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and comment if you have any questions. So let's talk about psychographics and demographics. You've probably heard the word demographics, right? It's the facts about the person that you're trying to reach. Now, before we get into this a little bit more, why is it so important that you know the demographics and you know your customer and what's important to them? If you want to create marketing that is going to be effective, it's far more effective if you're speaking to the person, the situation that they're in, the things that they care about, right? If you are trying to sell wedding dresses to women, if you target women who are in their 80s and 90s, you're probably not going to sell any wedding dresses, right? By the same token, if you target girls who are, you know, 12 to 20 years old, you're not going to sell as many wedding dresses, right? So knowing your exact target market, who are the people that are not only the most likely to buy your product, but who are going to also, you know, react to the content that you're putting out, react to the ads that you're putting out, it makes a lot of sense. When you are looking at things on the internet, you want things that are going to be relevant to you. If you never wanted to start a business, or you don't have a brand, or you're not doing any kind of content creation, this channel is probably not going to be interesting to you, right? It's because I talk about marketing here. So same kind of thing goes there. So it's extremely important in such a noisy and busy internet that you are creating content that's going to speak to specific groups of people. Everybody's always wondering what's in it for them. And if you're creating marketing that speaks to a specific problem that a group is having, or a specific problem that somebody with a certain value set has, it's going to be far more effective. And you're going to be able to reach and cut through the noise far easier. So let's talk about demographics and psychographics. Now, demographics are, as I mentioned, that's the facts about the person. So is this a person, a man or a woman? Do they have, how old are they? What is their income? What is their location? Where do they live? Those kind of questions are demographics. So those are strictly factual. There's not any kind of argument about that, right? And that is very important to have. So we need to know that, you know, if we had a product that we're selling, you know, like men's weightlifting equipment, that was like men's workout gear or something, knowing your target demographics is going to help you to sell more. But not only having demographics is important, but also psychographics. Now, what are psychographics? Psychographics are when you understand what makes a person tick. So it's the things that they love to do, their hobbies, their interests, their what they care about, what their values are, what their goals are. Things that are more qualitative, right? You have qualitative and quantitative. Quantitative are number-based and fact-based. Qualitative are how things make people feel, what they're thinking about, stuff that's not so cut and dry. Now, if you put both of these things together, you're going to have a lot of benefits. Number one, you're going to be able to create ads that are far more targeted. So if you just did a kind of shotgun blanket approach and you showed ads to everybody who was on Facebook, there would be a huge chance that you wouldn't be even hitting people that are in your target market. So the more find you can get, the better chance at success you're going to have, for sure. So that being said, it's also very, very important that you know what is important to your clients and your prospects from a qualitative standpoint, in that you need to understand, like, for example, people that are, you know, very concerned about the environment are very different than people who are not concerned about the environment. People that are, you know, liberal are very different than people that are conservative, right? And so the kind of content and the kind of ads and offers that you create for these people are going to be very, very different. So once you figure out kind of what their hot buttons are, what their goals are, what their fears are, what they think about, you're going to be able to create content that's just far more effective. Now let's think about this from the standpoint of talking about demographics and then psychographics. Let's say you have an Airbnb unit and you're trying to market it to get people to come to it. Pretty much anybody could stay at your Airbnb unit, right? All you have to do is be a human being. You can stay there. If you have the money for it, you can pay for it and buy a night there, whatever, right? But if you wanted to create content that was a lot more related to specific groups of people that you're trying to market to. Let's say you wanted to market to pet owners who can stay at your Airbnb unit. You could create content that said, hey, here's all of the fun things to do for dog owners in this town. Here's the dog walking festival that's going on. Here are the dog-friendly restaurants going on. Here's the dog-friendly events that are going on. It's just super targeted to somebody who has a dog who wants to travel with that dog. If somebody's traveling with that dog and you've made a customer avatar that is somebody who really cares about traveling with their pet and enjoying life with their pet, then you're creating, again, content that they're going to interact with, engage with. You can show people offers based on that your friendly, dog-friendly place that you have is something that you care about, right? You're going to be far more effective in creating that and understanding the psychographics of somebody who is a dog owner who's traveling with their pets and they want to have a good time versus just trying to target everybody. The internet is extremely noisy, extremely busy, and you need to cut through the noise. So how can you create content or ads that speak to specific people groups? In the ad targeting, you can just run through in Ads Manager and see in Facebook Ads Manager or in Google Ads, you can see all of the different demographics that they have, people that are interested in travel and people interested in specific hobbies. And you can really hone in on some good ideas on what you can use to create content that's going to speak to these specific groups. And it makes a lot of sense. You care about what's important to you. And so if you saw a brand or a business that's also showing interest in the things that you care about, you're going to react a lot more positively to that. So always think about how can I make this more laser focused? Think about what is the minimum viable audience that I can use to sell my product and have the biggest impact. Because if you make something that's for everybody, the old saying is that it's also for nobody. So try to figure out who are the people that we're trying to target and what are their values, what are their goals, what are their fears, and also hone in on those psychographics as well as the demographics. The more honed in that you can get, the better that your content's going to be and the more effective your marketing's going to be. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, any comments, you need help with anything, comment below. And don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you on the next video. Have a great day.